Hey, how's it going? Drainus here. Welcome back to Season of Discovery. This time with another fishing video for you and a good fishing spot. At the moment we are in Duskwalla Marsh, around the northeastern coast here. You can find fishing pools all along this coast. And most of the fishing pools will be fishing pools we have seen before. So we get the oily blackmouth pools again, also the firefin snapper pools. But we get a lot of ironbound trunks here. I'm not sure if this is the normal drop rate or that the drop rate is higher here. The ironbound trunks here are a little bit lower level than the mithril-bound trunks we could find in Tenerys. But yeah, the ironbound trunks also drop all of the cloth, except the runebolt cloth, and the greens will be a little bit lower level. But overall, yeah, the farm is pretty good. I haven't farmed that much yet, and as you can see, I have a lot of ironbound trunks already. Now most of the time this area is less contested than the other areas we have spoken about before, so most of the time you will only see people farming these turtles and yeah, some people leveling, but nothing you can't handle, and the pools respawn very quickly. We can also find the floating wreckage pool here again, so the floating wreckage pool will drop the ironbound trunks, but also the Rumzirum Black Label and some Strangelkelp. So this is yeah, a really good spot if you need to have some money, because all of the ironbound trunks here will contain good materials. You can sell them on the auction house or get some good recipes. So we got a couple of greens recipe. This one is also a little bit lower level than the recipes from the mithril-bound trunks. But yeah, we got a lot of the mana potions also. They can sell for a little bit on the auction house. Lots of mage weave. Also some heavy leather, of course. Some greater healing potions, always nice to have them. And the thick leather here. Now, the oily blackmouth and the firefin snapper can both be used with your alchemy skill to make the fire oil and also the blackmouth oil. Also nice to remember. Around the coast here, and especially around the ridges, there will be a lot of herbs, so goldthorn can spawn here. And goldthorn is worth a lot at the moment. We have also spoken about this in the alchemy video. But yeah, it is a pretty good herb to farm, to make your own potions or just to sell on the auction house. So definitely check this out. And keep your eye on the Mimi map for your, yeah, your spawns. Now, as I said, the pools can spawn all along this coast, but after a certain point, after this point, the mobs will be aggressive. So Shaman especially comes in handy here, because we have the Water Walk ability. Now, and this ability, yeah, can help you keep clear of the aggressive mobs and just fish out all of the pools along the coast. So this will be a big benefit, because most of the fishers will only go to this point and go back back south again. So we're now going across the point here and search for more pools. Now here's an example. There are some murlocs on this island, but we can just fish the pool up from this side. And this can work yeah, everywhere. So especially in the later phases when you can farm the elemental waters in Azera, this will also be very good, I think. Just to be able to stay on the water. And but yeah, definitely check out the Duskwalla Marsh here for your fishing pools. It can be pretty rewarding, and it is most of the time less contested than Tenerys, for example. But for now, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, and I see you in the next one. Bye.